Hi, I'm Veli from Greenwood Solutions. Today's presentation is on cable tray and how you calculate using a spreadsheet. So like the basic and advanced spreadsheet calculations for framing, I like to set out inputs and outputs in separate little boxes, or little tables. And as always, because I'm such a slow typer, I've decided to use some shortcuts. So we got the brand, the model, the cable tray length in mil, the cable tray width, the length of the run for the tray in question, buffer for mistakes, the cable tray lid length, because sometimes the lid length is not the same as the tray length, the overlap amount in millimeters. In other words, if you're actually going to overlap the tray, how many centimeters are you going to do that? Some people like to butt it up. If that's the case, just put in 1 millimeter. Spacing of the hex screws, so lid to the tray, the fixings. How far apart, distance between the supports, in other words, how the cable tray is supported. And are you using uni-strut or another kind of support? What length pieces are you using? And what lengths does uni-strut come in millimetres? And by the way, there's a spelling mistake. Now, as usual, I like to use yellow for the input cells. So I will just highlight those because I've already inputted them again. So here we go. Okay, cable tray brand, I put in Acme. Cable tray model Fusion, the cable tray length, 1000. Well, that's silly because most of the time it's 3000. So we'll change that. Now the cable tray width is, I've used the drop down list. So you can see I've made it, you can select from the 150, 300, 450 and 600. I've only allowed for one cable tray size at a time. So that you can select, there's a drop down list where you can select 150 up to 600 mil. What I suggest you do on your normal project, well, let's face it, you're gonna use a lot of different sizes, trays, is that carefully go through each segment. So if you're using 150 mil for X amount of the project, copy the results and open up another sheet and then paste as a value. Then you can go back to the first sheet and change that tray to the, say the next size up, 300 mil, and do the same thing. The length of the run, that's in meters, and I should put that, length of run in meters, and there it is, I've already put that, so let's stretch this out a little bit, maybe there we go. 100 meters, I can put 200. I can put whatever length I want in run. Now the buffer for mistakes made in percentage terms, I put in 2%. You can put up 10, 20, 30. In most cases, people tend not to make mistakes with cable tray, but if you've measured incorrectly or you've made a boom and cut some tray too short, this allows you a little bit of a buffer. So it's up to you what you put in there. Now, the cable length lid in millimeters is 3000. Now, notice in here, because I've selected 600, I referenced 600 here and here. Now, if I change the cable tray width to say 450, that references, and how I've done that is again, that horrible word, concatenation. So equals length of run 4C6, which is that, plus millimeter tray in meters, etc., and that's how you do that automatically. And the same for the cable tray lid. Now overlap amount, 30 mil. Spacing of hex screws, 1000. Distance between the supports, 1200. Are you using uni-strut? Yes. So what length pieces are you using? This is the lengths that go under the actual tray. So let's say we'll go back to the 600 tray. And let's say we have an overlap of 50 mil eight, so let's say it's 700 mil. Okay. And what length does the uni come in, or the structural support using? And you can input what you like. And are you using hold downs, yes or no? Now we come to the next lot of inputs. Let's do the same thing. Here we go. So this here allows you to calculate how many boxes you require. hex screws per box, splices per box, and you can see hold downs per box, channel nuts, the whole bit. So when you're ordering, you can say, well, I need X amount of boxes because I know that I need X amount of these particular components on site. That will come over here again, highlight, bang, and I put in 50. So you put in whatever. Whatever's the amount per box as a standard is. For instance, number of cable tray lids per pack, it could be 20, it could be 10, it could be whatever. You just got the same thing. Now for the most important or equally as important cable tray outputs. This is where the calculations go on. So number of 600 mil tray lengths is 68. And the length is 71, and obviously the length is going to be, you're gonna have more lengths than the actual of lid than you have the tray because you've got an overlap. Now, of course, these calculations, as you can see here, they round up, and you must always round up when it comes to sections of tray or rail or lid or something that you put together to create a particular run. Some of the calculations were fairly long. In their essence, they're not that complicated, but they do end up taking up a lot of room. So go through them carefully. And you may even see areas where you can improve on this actual spreadsheet. Now, the number of hex screws to attach to the lid, 402, because we've got 200 meters. And we're spacing at 1,000 mil, so you can see the calculation up here. So I've referenced C7, I've divided that by the spacings, and I've added one because, for instance, it's like fence palings. You've got that first one and that last one, and this calculation. 7 over C11 doesn't take that into account. It can't, so you have to add that one and then multiply it by two because you're actually affixing to both sides of the lid. Splices. So the splices, they relate to the number of cable tray lengths minus one. And like panel framing joiners, it's the same thing. Then you multiply that by two because you have two splices per join. And number of splice bolts. Okay, well, you can see here that I've just referenced the amount of splices and multiplied by two because you need two bolts. And now washers, if applicable, that references the number of splice bolts, and number of splice nuts references the splice washers. So you can see, we go to formulas, trace precedence, you can see the connection there. We go the same thing, you can see number of splices relates to number of lengths tray. So it's a really good thing when you're doing formulas to look at this trace precedence or trace dependence. You can see where everything relates. Splice nuts, same scenario, and hold down nuts. Well, you can see this is a slightly different calculation, okay? But again, it's referencing, let's see what it references. So it's referencing a few things here. The length of the run, the distance between the supports in millimeters, and are you using hold downs? Again, I urge you, whether you're doing your own spreadsheets or looking at other people's spreadsheets, to use this little function here. You know, the formulas, go to formulas and then trace precedence. So number of bolts for channel nuts obviously references the number of channel nuts, and you can see that. Okay. Number of uni-strut length pieces, right? Now, if we'd used non-uni-strut pieces, the question asked would be number of support pieces. And again, I've used an if statement. So if C13 equals yes, then I go number of uni-strut pieces. If no, it says number of support pieces. Now, the total length of uni-strut needed meters, and that gives you 118 meters. So effectively, we've got 168 pieces at 700 mil each, and this makes up 180. And then of course the number of lengths required. Now, this doesn't assume that you've got spare bits of uni strut. If you have, fine, that's great, use them. But this references again I-15, which is the total length, right, multiplied by 1,000, because we're being taught it's a millimeter to meter conversion, and then we divide by C15, what length does it come in, and then we round up to 30. So obviously the cable tray output section here references the information you've put in here. So this here will tell you how many boxes to buy of hex screw boxes or packs of cable tray, channel nut boxes, or number of splice nut boxes. That's a hard one to say quickly. So at the end of the day, we have got a balance of materials list. We can take this information here and this information here, put it onto another sheet of your spreadsheet, and then send that off to whoever, to the purchasing officer or whoever deals with purchasing the products in there. We've got a nice clean list of how many components are required. Now, we can do this with most aspects of the commercial solar process. So hopefully this makes a bit of sense to you. And if you want the actual spreadsheet, please subscribe. We hope you enjoy this presentation on cable tray calculations using a spreadsheet. If you have any questions, inquiries, any answers, please feel free to drop us a line and hit that subscribe button if you see fit. Thanks very much.